Students, and welcome back to the second session of Civics Chapter 2, Role of the Government in Health. In first part, we studied that what are the expectations of the people from the government. Then we studied the definition of health. Healthcare in India along with its negative and positive aspects. And at the end of the session, I had asked you to read two stories from the chapter. The first story was the story of Hakim Sheikh and the second one was Aman and Ranjan. I hope, students, you have read the story. Now, students, just we will recall that stories and we will start with the further explanation. So, the first story was of Hakim Sheikh. Now, Hakim Sheikh was the member of Pashchim Banga Khet Mazdur Samiti, an organization of agricultural laborer. He met with an accident and suffered a head injury. He was taken to a government hospital in Kolkata, but they refused to admit him because they did not have a spare bed. Another hospital did not have the facility or the specialized doctor necessary for his treatment. So in this way, he spent 14 hours in a critical state. And finally, he was admitted in a private hospital where he received treatment. He spent a lot of money on the treatment. Okay, students, so this was the first story. And the second story was of Aman and Ranjan. Both were two friends. They meet after a long time and they want to share their experiences. Aman and Ranjan both were not well. Aman went to one hospital and Ranjan went to another hospital. Where the Ranjan went, that was a very, what we can say, a posh hospital where he felt like he has visited any five-star hotel. Okay. So his daddy had paid 500 at the reception counter. The doctors and all the staff was very good to him. Okay, the doctor prescribed him medicines and it was done. But Aman's case was different. The hospital where he went, there was a huge queue, no proper facilities. The doctors were also not same, but the cost was very less. So if you have gone through these two stories, you must have understood that in India, healthcare system can be broadly categorized into two parts. So let's study, students. Healthcare in India. Okay, students. Healthcare in India. Now, healthcare in India can be broadly classified into two types, public health services and private health services. Now let's start with public health services. Now health centers and hospitals run by government are known as public health services. They provide quality healthcare services either free or at very low cost. So here you can recall the story of Ranjan and Aman, where Aman has to pay only rupees 150 for his treatment. So they provide health service at either free or very low cost, because even a poor can get treatment over there. Okay, so the public health services are available at both the places, in urban as well as rural areas. Okay, students. Now, the main function of this public health services is to prevent the spread of diseases such as TB, malaria, jaundice, cholera, etc. And if you go to see the current situation of the country, like the pandemic, it is the only the government hospitals who are controlling the situation. Most of the COVID patients are admitted in government hospitals. So the public health services, that is the government hospitals, play an important role in preventing all such communicable diseases. Okay, now you must be thinking, from where does this government make the expenses? Now, at the starting of the chapter, I told you, we elect the representatives and they form the government. At the same time, we people pay tax to the government, and this tax is utilized by the government for all these welfare facilities, and from that one is the public health service. Now next is private health services. Now the health service or the health centers which are not owned or controlled by government are known as private health services. Most of the private healthcare centers provide all facilities related to health at one place. So if you have visited any multi-specialty hospital, you must have seen over there the X-ray machine, then blood testing laboratory, then scanning. All these things are present at one place, but the people pay lot of money. Here, recall the example of Ranjan, where at the reception only he has to pay 500 rupees as case paper fee. Okay, so the people pay a lot of money for every service they used. And in India, large companies run hospitals. Now why so? Because most of the private hospitals are only for profit gain purpose, and that's why the big companies take it as an business students. So this is private health service. Let's move on to the next part. See, the picture itself is clear to you. The patients are sitting in the reception, and there itself the doctor is treating him. See the reception counter, how huge big queue is there for the case paper. Okay, but and in the wards, two patients on one bed, students. Yes, they cost very low, but the facilities which provide are not up to the mark. And exactly opposite to is private health services. See how clean and posh is the ward, well equipped operation theater, doctors operating the patients, all these things, very clean and hygiene. But students, we have to pay more over here, don't forget. Next, now how do this working of healthcare facilities? Okay, at rural areas we have village health workers and nurse. Now this village health workers and nurse work under supervision of doctors at primary health centers. So they are primary health centers, over there doctors are there, and under the supervision of these doctors, this village health workers and nurse works. These centers covers many village in a rural area. So the people from the nearby places, they can come over there for their treatment. Now this village health workers and nurses are, they deal with a common illness. Okay. Next, for private health facilities, even we have private health facilities over there. There we have registered medical practitioners, that is RMPs, what we call. They treat the patient over there in the private health services at village area. Next, at district level. At district level, we have district hospitals. Now, these hospitals are also supervised by the health centers, which we have already studied at urban level. At urban level, we have many hospitals as well as private hospitals, government as well as private hospitals. Also, large number of doctors, many of them providing specialized service. For example, if we, in a city, we have a specialized doctor for example, ENTs, that is for some of the doctors are heart specialists. So in this way, we have specialized doctor, and mostly they are privately owned. So their hospitals are privately owned. Now, this was about the public health and private health care services. Okay, students. Now, healthcare and equality. Okay, so let's start with the healthcare and equality. Private health services keep increasing than public health services in India. Cost of private services are too high. Okay, students, so if you visit any multi-specialty hospital, they will give you good treatment, but at the same time, you have to pay very high amount over there. So many people cannot afford them. So the expenses of the most of the big hospitals, they are not affordable by the many peoples, and they prefer to go to government hospitals. Only 20% of the Indian affordable for medicines for their illness. So only 20% of the Indian peoples are can afford to purchase a medicine for their illness. Now, women's health concerns are considered to be very less important. So as we know, India is a male dominated country. So in the case of health also, woman has been given inferior treatment, where her health is not considered that much important in the family. Not only women, but many tribal areas have few health centers. So the tribal people, they don't even get the facility of the medical services over there. So even they have to travel a long distance for their medical treatment. So in your textbook, on page number 27, there is a one pregnant lady has to travel many kilometers to see a qualified doctor. So this is a condition of the health system in India, students. Along with this, according to one study, 40% of the patients in hospitals have to borrow money or sell their possessions to pay for their medical expenses. So as already we have discussed that the cost of private health services are very expensive. So either the person has to borrow money or sell their possessions to pay the medical expenses. And most healthcare systems in towns and cities are privately run for a profit. So as I told, the big companies, they take this as a business to earn the profit. So healthcare systems in towns and cities are privately run for a profit. Now what has to be done? There are some responsibilities of the government. So now let's see what are the government responsibilities. To provide quality healthcare service to all citizens. Okay. It is the first responsibility of the government. And during this COVID situation, the government is doing that. They are providing the healthcare facilities to everyone. Basic medical facilities should be available to everyone and everywhere. So if this thing government take it seriously, then the picture which was there in your textbook, the pregnant lady who was traveling for a long distance for a qualified doctor, this would have not happened. So the medical facility which will be provided by the government, it should be very affordable. Even a poor can afford it. At the same time, improve the health situation of our people. So at one side, the government hospitals should also improve or increase the facilities, and at the same time, the government should also take care of the health situation of our people. A country's government and the people have to work together to improve the health of the nation. The government as well as the people, they have to work together to improve the health care of the nation. So the current situation, students, again, where the government is trying the level best to come over the COVID situation, here it's a responsibility of a common people to help them and cooperate them. So in this way, we together, the government and the common people have to work together to improve the health of the nation. Okay, students. So in this regard, in your textbook, two examples have given. The first example is of Kerala experience. What can be done? So in 1996, 40% of the state budget was given to the panchayat. So whatever the budget of the state was there, out of that 40% was given to the panchayat, means at the local level government. For what? So that the village planning was made proper for schools, water, food, women's education. So it means that the water supply schemes were checked, the working of schools and Anganwadis were ensured, and specific problems of the village were taken up. Even health centers were also improved at that time. So the local government was able to do all this with this 40% of budget which was given to them. But despite these efforts, Kerala faced problems such as storage of medicines, insufficient hospital beds, not enough doctors, and this problem needed to be addressed. So even though the Kerala is taking effort to improve the healthcare facility in their state, they are facing this problems. So students, this process will be on. Okay, where government is trying the level best to improve the condition of the healthcare systems in India, even the people or the citizens of that country has to contribute for it. Now the second, the Costa Rica approach. I want you to read that properly, the Costa Rica approach, and we will discuss about this in our online session. Okay, students, so this was the end of our chapter. Now, students, in these two sessions, I had told you about the important work, or the doctors are how important to us. Okay, students, so at the end of this session, I am sharing one link with you of a very beautiful video, which is tribute to the doctors who are working day and night in this pandemic situation. So please watch it. Okay, students, always remember, happiness is the highest form of health. Thank you, students.